सिविल डिपार्टमेंट, सुब्रल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज, सब्जेक्ट जियो टेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग 1, लेक्चरर 5. द टॉपिक इज थ्री फेस डायग्राम्स इन प्रॉब्लम्स. ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड सम प्रॉब्लम्स इन लास्ट क्लास. सो थ्री फेस डायग्राम इन सॉइल मास इन जनरल इन थ्री फेस सिस्टम composed of solids, liquids and gases phase. Solids means soil composition and liquids, waters, gases is air phase. Different phases present in the soil mass content be separated. The diagrammatic representation of different phases in soil mass is called phase diagram or block diagram. So it is the partially saturated system. So write the problem. Consider the phase diagram of the soil given below. The soil is completely saturated. The specific gravity of soil solids is 2.6. Take density of water as 10 kilonewton per meter square. Match the list 1 physical properties of soils with list 2 is corresponding values and select the correct answer using the codes in given below and draw the diagram. It is a completely saturated, only two phases, solids and water. Weight of solids is equal to 100 grams and weight of water is 20 grams. And write the list 1, list 2. First one is the list 1, water content. Second one, void ratio. Third one, porosity. And fourth one, saturated density. Here list 2, A 0.34, B 0.52, and C 20.53, and D 20%. Next one, options A, B, C, D. And top 1, 2, 3, 4. So A, cap C, B, D, and match. Which one is the match is correct using the this codes? Second option B, A, D, C. Third option C, A, C. D, fourth option DB AC. So write the solution. First one is the water content. Water content indicate the small w equal to. The formula of the water content is the ratio of weight of the water to weight of solids multiply with 100. So here weight of water is 20 and weight of solids is equal to 100. So shown in figure, weight of solids equal 100 grams and weight of water is 20 grams. So 20 by 100 multiply with 100 equal 20%. Next one, second list, void ratio. Void ratio, it is indicated small e. And void ratio formula is
water content into specific gravity divided by saturation. So is it equal to water content is 20% means 0.2, and specific gravity is given problem 2.6. Take and S is the soil is completely saturated means 100% and equal to 1. So the water content 0.2 and specific gravity 2.6, saturated is 1, equal to 0.52. Next, third one list is porosity. It is porosity is indicated to small n. Porosity formula is equal to small e divided by 1 plus e. Means void ratio divided by 1 plus void ratio. Void ratio is 0.52 divided by 1 plus 0.52. It is equal to 0.34. Next one is the fourth one, saturated density. Saturated density is indicated to gamma saturation. So it is formula capital G, specific gravity plus 1 plus 1 into E. E means void ratio divided by 1 plus E. So capital G specific gravity is 2.6 plus small e is the void ratio 0.52. Next one, 1 plus e is the 1 plus e is the void ratio 0.52 into gamma w. Gamma w means density of water is 10 kilonewton per square meter is given in problem. So totally multiplied, answer is 20.53 kilonewton per cubic meter. So first one, water content is 20%, option D. Next one, void ratio is the 0.52, option B, DB. So option is small d, DBAC. Porosity 0.34 and saturation of density is 0.52. Next problem is, write the next problem. Soil sample A and B have void ratio of 0.5 and 0.7 respectively. If 1.5 cubic meter of soil sample A and 1.7 cubic meter of sample B are mixed to form sample C having volume of 3.2 cubic meters, which one of the following correctly represent the porosity of sample C? So options A is 50%, B is 37.5%, and C is 100%, and D is 33.33%. Let solution go to write the data. Soil A, soil B, soil C. Means soil 1, soil 2, soil 3. Here soil 1 in or A is given void ratio and volume, and soil B and 2 is given void ratio E and volume 2, and soil C is only volume 3. Then here find out the soil C R3 in find out porosity of sample. So right now soil A is void ratio E equal to 0.5 and volume V1 equal to 1.5 cubic meters, and soil B E2 equal 0.7 and volume V2 equal to 1.7 cubic meters. Similarly, soil C V3 equal to 3.2 cubic meters. Only volume is given in soil 3 or soil C. Even after mixing, the volume of solids of each soil will be same in mixed sample. So the solids in soil A, so Vs1 equal to volume of solids V1 by 1 plus E1. V1 means volume of soil 1. E is the void ratio of soil 1. So V1 is the 1.5 cubic meters plus 1 plus E1 means void ratio 0.5. It is equal to 1 cubic meter. Next, similarly, the solids in soil B. Volume of solids 2. Vs2 equal to V2, volume in solids 2 or B solids. V2 divided by 1 plus E2. V2 means second solids in volume 1.7 cubic meters. 1 plus E2 means void volume of voids in second solids 1 plus 0.7. So 1.7 is volume 2 V2 and void ratio E2 is 0.7. Substitute 1.7 divided by 1 plus 0.7 is equal to 1 cubic meter. So solids of soil in A is 1 cubic meter, solids in soil B is 1 cubic meter. Therefore, total volume of solids in soil C, Vs3, Vs1 plus Vs2. It is the mixing of volume of solids. Each soil will be same in mixed sample. So Vs1 plus Vs2 equal to 2 cubic meter. Then volume of void in soil C. Volume of voids Vv equal to V3 minus Vs3 equal to total volume of V3 in soil C is 3.2 cubic meters V3. So minus total volume of solids in C Vs3 equal to 3.2 minus 2. Here Vs3 is 2 cubic meters. Already we give the V3, total volume V3, this is 3.2 equal to 1.2 cubic meters. Then we find out in problem porosity. So porosity is indicated to N. Therefore porosity N equal to volume of voids divided by volume in C, in solids C. So volume of voids 1.2 in soil C divided by volume in soil C 3.2 is equal to 0.375 is porosity. So options is 100% is taken, 37.5%. So hence option B is correct. Next problem. Which one of the following the water content? Which one of the following is the water content of mixed soil? Made from 1 kg of soil. Same A, it is A soil with water content of 100% and 1 kg of soil. It's a B soil with water content of 50%. So options is A is 66%, B is 71%, C is 75%, and D is 82%. Next solution, write the given data. So here same soil A and soil B in weight of the soil is given. And water content is given. Soil A is 100% and soil B is 50%. So write down soil A. It is indicated 1. Weight of soil W 1 equal to 1 kg. Next water content is 100%. Next soil B, it is 2. Weight of the soil W2 equal to 1 kg, and water content small W2 equal 50%. Is weight is indicated to capital W and water content W is small W. And soil C W3, W1 plus W2. Next then find out the water content W3. We find in soil A, soil weight is W1 1 kg and water content W1 is 100%. It is mixed soil of. So first we find out the water content small W. Therefore water content small W equal to the ratio of weight of water divided by weight of solids. Weight of water is indicated to WW and weight of solids indicated WS with multiplied with 100. So from equation, water content divided by 100 equal to WW by WS, weight of water divided by weight of solids. So both sides adding 1, W by 100 plus 1 equal to WW by WS plus 1. Then this equation solve finally. W by 100 plus 1 equal to WW plus WS by WS. WW plus WS is equal to total weight of soil C. So next one, weight of the solids in soil A. Weight of solids at A equal to weight of solids 1000 means 1 kg in grams divided by 1 plus 1. It is equal to 500 grams. Weight of water content at A equal to 1000 minus 500 equal to 500 grams. So here formula, weight of solids at A. Weight of the soil divided by 1 plus weight of the water content 100% means 1. 1000 divided by 2 equal to 500. Next one, weight of the solids in soil B. Weight of solids at B equal to weight of solids W2 equal to 1 kg means 1000 grams divided by the water content is 15% means 0.5. 1000 divided by 0.5 plus 1 equal to 666.7 grams. Next one, weight of the water at B, 1000 minus weight of solids. So the water content is 333.0 grams. Here solids at A, weight of the solids minus water content is 100%. So here weight of solids 1000 means 1 kg 100,000 grams minus weight of the solids would be 666.7. So then finally 333.33 grams. Weight of solids mix. Weight of solids at A plus weight of solids at B equal to 500 plus 666.7. Finally, then we'll come to 1166.7 grams. It is the weight of solids. Similarly, weight of water content mix. Weight of water content at A and water content at B. 500 plus 333.3 grams. Finally, then we'll come to 833.3 grams. So finally, from A and B, water content equal to weight of water content 1 mix, weight of solids 1 mix. So weight of water content 833.3 divided by weight of solids 1. 1166.7 into multiply 100 equal to 71% water content. So option is B. Next problem. A soil sample has void ratio of 35%. The specific gravity of solids is 2.7. Calculate the one is the porosity. Second one is dry density. And third one is the unit weight of if the soil is 75% saturated in unit weight. So fourth one is unit weight of the soil is submerged. So first one, given the data solution, given void ratio is 35%. Void ratio is indicated to small e. So e equal to and specific gravity is GS 2.7. So we find out the one by one. First one is the porosity. We know the porosity. Porosity is indicated to N. N equal to void ratio divided by 1 plus void ratio. Small e divided by 1 plus e. So e is the void ratio is 35% equal to 0.35. E is 35%. So N equal to E by 1 plus E. E means 35%. You write the 0.35 divided by N plus 0.35. It is equal to 0.259. So porosity is 0.259. Next one is the dry density. dry density is indicated to the gamma t. So we know the formula gs plus sc divided by 1 plus c into gamma w. So gs means specific gravity, s means dry density, e is the void ratio, gamma w unit weight of the water. So unit weight of the water is 9.81. for dry density saturation s equal to 0, therefore gamma d equal to gs gamma w by 1 plus c. dry density gamma d, so gs means 2.7 specific gravity into gamma w unit weight of water 9.81 divided by 1 plus e means void ratio 0.35. already you give the void ratio is equal to 35%, so write the 0.35. then finally dry density gamma d equal to 19.62 kilonewton per cubic meter. Next one, third one is the when soil is 75% saturated, that is S equal to 0.75. The above is dry density means saturation is no saturation, S equal to 0. Here saturation is 0.75. So same formula, gamma equal to gs plus 1 sc divided by m plus c into gamma w. Specific gravity is just 2.75 plus sc saturated 0.75 multiply with e is the void ratio 0.35 divided by 1 plus c means 1 plus e is the void ratio 0.35 multiply it the unit weight of the water gamma w equal 9.81. it is equal to the final values multiplication total all values 21.53 kilonewton per meter cube or cubic meter. Next fourth one is the unit weight of the soil is submerged. We know gamma submerged is equal to gamma saturation minus gamma w, means unit weight of the water. Gamma saturation is gs plus s e divided by 1 plus e into gamma w. Here submerged s equal to 0, then finally gs divided by 1 plus into gamma w minus gamma w. Here take the common gamma w unit weight of the water, gs minus 1 divided by 1 plus c. So gs means specific gravity is 2.7 minus 1 divided by 1 plus void ratio is 35%, then write note 0.35 into the gamma w unit weight of the water is 9.81. then we finally solve the values and substitute 12.35 kilonewton per cubic meter. It is submerged. Next problem, a sampler with volume of a sampler with volume of 60 cubic meter is filled with saturated soil sample. The specific gravity of soil solids is 2.65. when the above and dry soil is poured into the graduated cylinder filled with water, it displaces 40 cubic meter of water. What is the natural moisture content and dry unit weight of the soil? Write the problem fastly. Here sampler total volume is the 60 cubic meter. Filled with the saturated soil sample. And specific gravity of the soil is 2.65. In woven dry soil poured into the graduated cylinder filled with water and it's displaced 40 cubic meter of water. Then we find out the moisture of content and dry unit weight of the soil. So first one, three phase diagram, drum. So three phase diagram is phase, first phase is solid, second phase is water, and third layer is the air. So here volumes, volume of solids, volume of water, volume of air. So volume of fluids is known as volume of water plus volume of air. It is known as volume of fluids, VV. So total volume is V. Then solution, write the data. Volume of soil sample is equal to volume of sampler. So V equal to total volume, 60 cubic meter. When the soil sample poured into the graduated cylinder, it displays 40 cubic meter of water. Then volume of soil solids is Vs equal to 40 cubic meter. Displace the water 40 cubic meter, then solid solids is 40 cubic meter. Then total volume V equal to volume of voids plus volume of solids. Then we know the total volume plus voids, solids of volume. Then we find out the volume of voids. Then volume of voids equal to V minus Vs, total volume minus volume of solids. So total volume is the 60 cubic meter minus volume of solids is 40 cubic meter. Then finally, volume of fluids equal to 20 cubic meters, centimeter cubics. Sorry, all units are centimeter cubes. Cubic centimeters. Here total volume is 60 cubic centimeters and solids, volume of solids is 40 cubic centimeters. Then finally volume of fluids come to the 20 cubic centimeters. Then next one, void ratio, small e is equal to volume of fluids divided by volume of solids. Volume of fluids is 20 cubic centimeters and divided by volume of solids is 40. So equal to 20 by 40 equal to 0.5. It is the void ratio E. Next one, now you have E equal to 0.5 and S equal to 1. GS equal to specific gravity 2.65 and using SC equal to W into GS. We find out the moisture content. Then we using this formula. Here fully saturated, then we give 100%, so S is equal to 1. Moisture content W equal to SC by divided by GS. So we find out the moisture content W, then GS is go to from left side and SC by GS. So then S is 1 and E is the void ratio 0.5 and S is equal to 1. So 1 into 0.5 divided by specific gravity, already we given the problem. Specific gravity of soil solids is 2.65. So GS is equal to 2.65 equal to multiply 18.86% moisture content. We know that gamma D, dry density of solids equal to gamma T by 1 plus moisture content W. So gamma T equal to bulk unit weight. then gamma t equal to g plus sc by 1 plus c into gamma w. Already we know the g is the specific gravity 2.65, s is 1, and e is the 0.5 divided by 1 plus c, g 1 plus 0.5 multiply gamma w. Gamma w unit weight of the water 9.81 R1000. Here fully saturated, so then 1000 is finally substituted. All values is coming from value is the 2.1 gram per cubic centimeter cc means. Hence gamma d equal gamma t by 1 plus w. Gamma t is value 2.1 divided by 1 plus w. 1 plus w means water moisture water content 18. Then finally value is 0.1886. So substitute in w value, then finally gamma d equal to 1.76 gram per cubic centimeter. Next problem, this is the last problem in this class. Write the problem. The void ratio and specific gravity of sample. The void ratio and specific gravity of sample of clay are 0.73 and 2.7 respectively. The voids are 92% saturated. Find the bulk density and dry density. And the water content. What would be the water content for the complete saturation? The void ratio remaining the same. So given data, small is void ratio is, and specific gravity is given. Void ratio is 0.73 and specific gravity is 2.7. Write note, E is the 0.73 and capital G equal 2.7. And voids are 92% saturated and S equal to 92%. So rho W equal to 1 gram cubic centimeter. Then bulk density. Rho T, it is indicated, the formula is G plus SC by 1 plus C into rho W. Here, specific gravity G is 2.7 and is, these values are above. All values substitute, SC is equal to 0.92 into multiply E small e, porosity, void ratio, 0.73 divided by 1 plus C, void ratio, E means 0.73 multiply with rho W, 1 gram per cubic centimeter, then finally come to the all values are multiplied, rho t equal to 1.948 gram per cubic centimeters. Next one, dry density, rho d equal to rho t by 1 plus w using s equal wg. The water content, moisture of water content s by g, then saturated water SC equal 0.92 multiply with E is the void ratio 0.73 divided by specific gravity is 2.7 equal to 0.248 R percentage in 24.87%. Next, substituting the W value in rho D. Rho D equal to PT value is coming 1.948. And 1 plus W. W is 24% or 0.245. So 1.948 plus 0.1 plus 0.248. Then finally, rho d equal to 1.560. So it is rho d is the dry density. Let water content of W for full saturation at given void ratio. Here we find out the saturation is 92%. Then we find out the water content of complete saturation. So let water content W is full saturation. Full saturation means complete saturation at given void ratio. Now S equal to 100% and E equal to 0.73. Then we know the S equal to WG. W equal to SE by G. S means fully saturated rate, means 100% taken 1. Multiply the E is the void ratio 0.73 and G is the specific gravity 2.7. Here already we'll taken void ratio 0.73, specific gravity 2.7. Then we will substitute the all values. Water content is 0.2703 or 27%. So next is also another problem. Rightly, fastly. A compacted cylinder specimen of 50 mm diameter and 100 mm long is to be prepared from dry soil. If the specimen is required to have water content of 15% and the percentage of air void is 20%, calculate the weight of soil and water required in the preparation of soil whose specific gravity is 2.69. So phase diagram is solids, water and air, total volume V, and volume of solids Vs, volume of water Vw, and volume of air Va. Next, here compacted cylinder is given. Here find out the volume pi by 4 into d square into height. So solution, volume of sample is equal to volume of cylinder. So volume of sample is V. It is volume of cylinder. Cylinder, how to formula is pi by 4 into d square into h, diameter of the cylinder. So equal to pi by 4 into d square. D square is 5 square. Diameter is, specimen of diameter is 50 mm. Here come to convert it into centimeters. 5 square multiply with 100 mm to convert into centimeters, 10. H is the long height. So pi by 4 into 5 square into 10. This is the units are mm to centimeters converted. Then finally volume is equal to 196.35 cubic centimeter cc means. Next one, water content W equal to volume of weight of water divided by weight of solids. Weight of water equal to volume of water multiply the gamma W and weight of solids, volume of solids into gamma S. Here VW by VS into G. So W is the water content 15% means 0.15, substitute VW is the, and divided by VS into G. Specific gravity of the water is divided by gamma W by gamma S equal to 1 by G. Then volume of water equal to this cross multiply, then Vs into G taken left side. So Vw equal to 0.15 into Vs into G. 0.15 into Vs into specific gravity is already taken from problem. The specific gravity is 2.69, substitute, then finally Vw equal to 0.40 Vs. Also the percentage of air void rate Na equal to Va by V. Is the percentage of air void is 20%, already is given problem. 20% value is 0.2. Then
0.2 equal to Va by V, then multiply by Va equal to 0.2 into V. So total volume is equal to volume of solids plus volume of water plus volume of air. Then total volume Vs plus volume of water is 0.4 Vs plus Va is the 0.2 V, and totally added total V minus 0.2 is taken from left side. V minus 0.2, then coming after value is 0.8 V equal to 1 plus 1 Vs plus 0.4 Vs, 1.4 Vs. Next Vs equal to 0.8 by 1.4 V. Then finally 0.8 into V. Total volume is the 196.35 substituted in V value. Then Vs equal to 112.11 cubic centimeter. Then let Ws be the weight of the soil solids. We prepare soil whose specific gravity is 2.69. We know now capital G equal to weight of solids divided by volume of solids into gamma W. Ws equal to G into Vs into is taken left side, gamma W. G is the specific gravity 2.69 multiply with volume of solids is 112.11, multiply unit weight of water is 1001. Then finally Ws is equal to volume of weight of solids equal to 301.6 grams. Next finally weight of the dry soil, weight of the solids equal to 301.6. let WW weight of the water of prepared soil whose specific gravity is 2.69. So WW equal to W into WS, water content 0.15, multiply the weight of the solids 301.6 grams. Therefore finally weight of water content is 45.24 grams. Thank you. Any doubt? I'm asking. Thank you for having me.